Hello, Mr. Picasso. How are you?
Profe,
¿Cómo está?
bien, ¿y usted?
Bien, aquí checando
¿Qué
cosas.
cree, profe?
¿Qué creo?
Tengo que irme a entrenar ahorita.
¿Cómo crees? ¿Y eso?
Pues es que se cambió el horario a las 12. Pues me hago
Ajá.
una hora de aquí a allá, así que ya me voy.
Y entonces, ¿no vas a estar ahorita?
Ahorita no, pues nada más para a decirle que no va a estar, pero voy a pedir los trabajos y se los mando el viernes, mañana.
Claro. Bueno, sí, ya me avisaste. Sí, sin problema, mister. ¿Sale?
Ok, teacher.
Bueno,
See
pues,
you.
see you. Okay. Ok. Vaya, Circe, hoy sí entró. Excelente. ¿Cómo que cuál es el ID? ¿Ya se lo olvidó este jovencito? Okay. I have three chats. Come on. Profesor, profesor, buenos días. Ah, hello, good morning, Abigail. Ay, ahora, ¿por qué muchos están teniendo fallas? Estoy recibiendo, recibiendo. Perdón por eso. Okay, guys. So, yesterday we were checking this. Lo voy a poner de nuevo a cuenta. Okay, you have this topic already in your notebook, okay? So it's not necessary to copy because you already have it. Object pronoun. Yes? And I told you here the object pronoun is me, you, him, her, it, us, them. Okay, and this one refers to happy. This one refers to I. You, he, she, it, we, and they. Okay, and also ayer que estábamos haciendo los ejercicios, yes, I told you always they appear after the verb. Yes, so we can say, Liz sent me an email this send. Sends me an email every day. Okay. Frank helps us to paint our home. We have they make her to come to the practice. Okay, so what I told you in this is that we have verbs, sends, helps, and make. And automatically we insert, yes, who is receiving this instruction. Okay, pero siempre iniciamos our sentences with a person, Liz, Frank, they. Okay, so this is the topic of object pronouns. That yesterday we were checking yesterday this topic, and lo hicieron bien in the exercise. Yes, now we have a second exercise here in the book. ¿Sale? Entonces lo empezamos a sacar y también para que hagamos the application of this topic in the correct exercise. So lo sacamos y nos vamos a la página 133. Ok, y aquí estamos en la 133. Is this exercise right here? Yes, this is the exercise. So right there you have with the red arrow. Okay. Cuatri, nivel B, we are. Okay. Okay, guys. So here we have Yes, object pronouns, I, me, we, us. Bueno, ahí lo tenemos arriba, ok. Right here. I, me, we, us, you, you, he, him, she, her, they, them. Y solamente it, we repeat. Ok, so circle the correct options. We are having a party on Saturday. Do you think John will come, would like to come? Why don't you ask her, ask him, or ask me?
Him?
What for you is the correct answer?
Him?
Him. Yes, that one is the correct answer. Okay, number two. My grandparents are visiting us right now. Oh, yeah. Please say hello. Say hello to him, to us, to them, for me.
Them.
Excellent. To them. Mm-hmm. So we circle them. Parece que ya lo tienen dominado. Is your brother coming to my party this weekend? Yes, he is. And he is bringing a special gift for him, for it, for you. What is the correct?
Him.
For him. Mm-hmm. Correct. Do you like soccer? Do I like soccer? I love them. I love you. I love it. What is the correct answer?
Them.
Okay, but we're talking about soccer. Soccer is a singular. It is the correct one. My mom is starting a new job next week. Really? Tell her, tell him. Tell you good luck. What is it again, please?
Her.
Her. Mm-hmm. Because it's my mom. Can I ask her, ask us, ask you a question? Yeah, sure. Thing. What do you want to ask?
Us?
Can I ask us a question? Not really, mister. I don't think so. That is the correct one. Ask you a question because it's for you. It's para ti. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, you show domination of the topic. Okay. Sometimes it's confusing for you. To have this relation, but that is only with practice. And obviously, the application of this is in a moment. So can I erase? Yes, can I erase? ¿Puedo borrar, chicos? Can I erase? Yes, sorry, you didn't tell me. Okay, so let's go back to page 37. More application of this topic. Okay, again, the red arrow is here in exercise D. Replace the both words with object pronouns. Then check your accuracy, tell a partner about things you buy for the people in your family. Okay. So right there we have, in parentheses, we have one person. That person needs an object pronoun. My dad, number one, my dad loves cooking. I always buy cookbooks for, and it's my dad. My dad is a boy. The object pronoun is him. He loves cookbooks.
Eat.
Okay. In fact, it is the correct answer. Yes. ¿Por qué no te aceptaría it? Porque aquí, si te das cuenta, dice cook books. Okay. So, nada más fíjate si este cookbook o cookbooks is singular o plural. Si sería singular.
Them.
Exacto. Si sería singular, sería it. And that answer will be great. Pero como son cookbooks, plural, them. Mm-hmm. Okay, so only in that one, yes, we need to put more your emphasis to pay more attention, yes, and to get your suitable answer. My sister is difficult to buy for, I usually get. My sister. What is the correct object pronoun for my sister?
Her.
Yeah. Wait. I usually get her gift cards to her favorite stores. She likes gift cards. Gift cards. What is the correct object pronoun for gift cards? It's very similar a la que hicimos anteriormente with the cookbooks. Check if the object is singular or plural, and then make your best selection.
Them.
Them, exactly. She likes them because she can choose the clothes she wants. Mm-hmm. Music is my parents' passion. They love music. They love.
Ahí sí sería it, profe.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Because it's only one music. They love it. It's really easy to buy a gift for my parents. Remember that my parents are two, mom and dad. So then.
Them igual.
Them, exactly. Mm-hmm. Okay, so así como le están haciendo, pay attention to this y tendrás ya todo resuelto muy bien. Okay, you copy, guys? ¿Ya copiaron? Para que pueda borrar. Yes, ready? Okay. Sale, vamos a ver this video. Yes. Do you want to buy the same thing as Carlo? I think is the name. Okay, let's watch this video. So it's Christmas, it's December. Many people go and buy many things for mom, for dad, brother, sister, yeah, uncle, aunts, cousins, etc., best friends. Okay, so check, this is the perfect unit for you. Yes, to check in December. Do you want to buy the same objects as Carlo? Check. Oh, está muy bajito el volumen. Let me check my volume. Aparte es, bueno, sí está un poquito bajo, pero no es mucho. A ver si ahorita se escucha más. What is the gift? Ahí lo enseña. What is the gift? It's a computer. It's a tablet. It's a book. What is it? Ahí lo enseña. Chéquense. What is that? Right there, you check on the screen. What is it? No? Ahora vamos a ver qué dice. Notebook. Yes, a notebook. Caio, yes, bought a notebook for his best friend. Okay, problems, guys. No, vámonos a la aplicación. Aplicación de todo este vocabulary, grammar, object pronouns, que ya lo tienen dominado. Ok, ¿dónde vamos a hacer this application? Right here, on your workbook. So, empezamos a sacar su workbook. Thank you. Okay. So, here we are. All the vocabulary, yes, and the grammar that we check now is here in the application of these exercises. Okay, so ya estamos en la página 28 y 29. Naming gift items. Okay, so all of these are gifts. Remember the vocabulary word gift. Read the sentences about each person and then choose the correct gift. Alex works in a garden. So what is the correct gift for Alex? A bouquet of flowers, a phone charger, or a candle? What is the correct gift for Alex?
Letter A.
Exactly. A bouquet of flowers. Yeah, because Alex is passionate about flowers. Number two. Jose loves his laptop. Perfect gift. Candy, perfume, or speakers for Jose. Students.
Letter C.
Mm-hmm. Speakers. Number three. Marta always wears earrings, a purse, jewelry, or a phone charger. A purse, jewelry, or a phone charger.
Purse.
A purse. That can be a good option, but not really because she wears earrings. So, to Marta, she likes a lot earrings. So another similar thing for earrings.
Letter B.
Mm-hmm. Yes, jewelry. Four. Jonathan always wears comfortable clothes. A candle.
A sweater.
A sweatshirt. Mm-hmm. Five. Sari often eats desserts. Perfect gift. Candy, candle, or perfume. Sari often eats desserts. You don't know what a dessert is? Postres. So what is the perfect gift for Sari?
Candy. Letter A.
Letter A, a candy. Six. It's really difficult to buy gifts for Tony. A phone charger, a candle or a gift card. It's very difficult, this person.
Letter C.
Exactly. Letter C. Okay, grammar. Ah, yes, I have time. Grammar. Complete the sentences with the correct words in the box. Her, him, it, me, them, us, you. This topic is very practical and easy for you. I always give my mom a bouquet of flowers. Is the best gift for her because she's my mom. Number two, sometimes I buy candy for my brother. It makes happy.
Me?
You say him? Mm-hmm. Him? Yes. Sometimes I buy candy for my brother, so my brother is him. It makes him happy. Mm-hmm. So remember, okay, I'm going to do this. Not to use one more time him. Tomorrow is your birthday. I'm giving speakers for your laptop. Tomorrow is your birthday. I am giving. No, tomorrow is your birthday. I am giving speakers for your laptop.
You.
I'm giving you. Don't pay. Okay, wait. I'm giving you speakers for your laptop. My brother, sister, and I are going to my grandparents' house on Sunday. They often invite for a family dinner.
Them?
No.
Us?
Us. Because he's my brother, my sister, and I, or me, so us. I have a candle for you. I hope you like. I have a candle for you. I hope you like.
It.
Thank you. Okay, one more. Okay, I have 4 minutes. Six. My friends know what I like. They always buy greater gifts for my friends. Know what I like. They always buy
them.
No, not really. Wait, wait, wait. My friends know what I like. They always buy great gifts for
me.
Me. I'm getting new pants for my sister. I'm budging. So which one is? There is only one. I'm getting new pants for my sister. I'm budging.
Them.
Them. Here. Exactly. Okay, buying them because they are pants. Okay, yes. So estamos aplicando, chicos, todo lo que aprendimos el día de ayer. ¿Sí? Solamente eso. ¿Sí? Vocabulary for gifts, object pronouns. Lo estamos aplicando ahorita. ¿Ok? Entonces, de ahí no me salgo el día de, bueno, el día de ayer, el de hoy, no me salgo de ahí. Cuando terminemos esto, pues sí vamos a ver algo distinto, pero es complemento. No es de que, ay, el tema de ya lo acabamos, ahora vamos a algo nuevo. No, sigo complementando, ¿sí? Pero ahorita, particularly in this lesson, yes, solamente vemos vocabulary of gifts, yes, and object pronouns, así como nos dice el ejercicio de la siguiente página. Rewrite the sentences using an object pronoun. So tenemos que reescribirla, all right? No está ya hecha. We rewrite it. Donaki is Yankees baseball fan. He watches the Yankees play every day, every weekend. ¿Sí? Tenemos que reemplazar las palabras o palabras que están en negrillas. So, nos dice entonces. Donald is a Yankees baseball fan. He watches them play every weekend. So vamos a reemplazar esa. Ok. Vamos a ver. ¿Cómo quedaría esta? Number two. Ah, ya no me va a dar tiempo.